Hello friends, this is Pete, ham radio call sign K7PP, and we're out in the shop again today. We're going to be taking a look at the Hammarlund HQ180 Alpha RF alignment. RF alignment's just absolutely plumb silly easy. You're going to go, is that all there is? You mean that's it? Well, we'll go through it step by step and you'll see that I'm right. Getting set up initially is pretty easy. We're going to first identify some of the things that we're going to be working with while I have the chassis up on end. And one of those things is the RF tuning capacitors. These are the output tuning capacitors for each of the bands. And you notice they've got a little bit of glyptol on them, and there's a reason for that. They've already been adjusted at the factory, and while you definitely can find a peak on each one, what they're being used for is to actually define the LC ratio of the output of the RF amplifier so that the radio stays peaked on whatever channel you select. In other words, these aren't the only tuning capacitors. There's a large gang tuning capacitor underneath the cover on the top side, and what these do is simply make sure that 3.8 is peaked at 3.8, 3.9 is peaked at 3.9. If they're not adjusted properly, you'll find that your RF tuning may end up falling off at each end of the band, or at one end of the band, or at both ends of the band. So these have been adjusted to provide the correct LC ratio. So what that leaves us with is tuning the different RF stages from the top of the radio, and we're going to use the individual selective cans that are connected when you switch the bands to different bands to do the actual RF peaking for us. Now, if you've had a failure of one of these caps, or there's been a failure where you've had to replace one of the cans, then it gets a little more dicey and you'll have to select the appropriate capacitor and play calibration cat and mouse up and down the dial until you get the balance adjusted correctly. So that's the explanation, the long version of it, and we're going to lay the radio down so we can get at the alignment on the top. We're going to come up here, and you'll see I've got a test clip lead going to a wire that I've kind of temporarily soldered in, and that wire goes to a pin on V8, which is a 6BV8, and it's essentially the product detector output. You're going to find a choke that comes off of pin 6 of the 6BV8, and it's called L8. And at the end of L8, there is a capacitor, bypass capacitor to the ground, C22, and it's a double odd 2 capacitor. And right where those two meet a junction, that's where we're going to connect the VTVM, or voltmeter, so that we can measure output. And as you can see, I do have a VTVM set up, and I'm looking at the output of the product detector. And I am injecting a signal right now. So stand by here a second, and we'll lay the radio back down. Okay, got the radio laid on its upright end here, and we're looking at the initial settings. So for setting RF, you're going to want to be at 3 kilohertz bandwidth. You're going to want to be in the AM position. You're going to want to be with sidebands selected at both. The slot frequency tune all the way over to the left. And the others don't really matter on this side. You're going to pick the band that you're going to start with. And I'm going to start with 1.05 to 2.05. And I've already selected the frequency, which is 1.8 megahertz, 160 meter band. I've turned my ABC off, I should say. Noise limiter off. Antenna is peaked for maximum. Crystal calibrator is off, and we're ready to go. And you'll notice that we're not going to be seeing a meter display, S-meter display, while we have the ABC switch off. All right, but we are getting a reading up here. And we're going to go over to the book, and the book is going to define the different settings for the different bands and tell you which transformer. And in this particular case, we're going to be starting with the frequency that is labeled uh, 1.1. And 1.1 is shown to be T13. There's only one adjustment in the cam. So if you go up here to T13 and follow the arrow down, you're going to see that it's the middle cam. All right, so the middle cam would be this one right here. And I've got a hex tool. It's plastic, should be plastic. And we'll come up to the meter here and we'll peek. There's our peak right there. Now we're in business. And one of the things you might want to do, if I were you, is align your antenna to the center position, straight up and down. And this way, no matter which band you select, you're going to be in pretty good shape as far as not having to adjust the antenna tuning. It will be right dead center of in the middle of the range. So that's very desirable. The next stage is going to be the output of the RF amplifier, and the output of the RF amplifier is tuned by transformer T19, and this is one of those transformers that's got two adjustments inside, one for the very bottom band, one for the top band. So I'm going to tune T19 bottom, and if you look in here closely, you'll see T19, and it goes to this transformer here in the third row, and we're going to be going to the bottom of the coil, and I'm pushing the tuning tool all the way down in there. See how far down it goes? So now I've engaged the bottom coil and I should be able to get a good peek right there. Okay, once I've done that, pull the tuning tool out and pull it through the next slug and out. You might wonder why I started with 1.85, one band up from the bottom. Well, that's because the tuning slug, as I'm pulling the tuning slug out, the next band would be the very bottom band, and that would be the top slug. So that keeps me from accidentally diddling or tweaking or adjusting the bottom slug when I'm tuning, and that's especially important when you're tuning the local oscillator. Okay, next frequency, or band, is the bottom of the broadcast band, and I'm going to pick a frequency, how about 900 kilohertz. There's 900 kilohertz. I'm going to come up to my signal generator. We're not really worried about accuracy right now. We're going to be tweaking the oscillators a little bit later. So 900 kilohertz, I'm going to switch to the 300 to 950 kilohertz band of frequencies, and I'm going to tune up the band until I reach the 900 kilohertz, and that's right there. There we go on the meter. Excellent. Okay, now we come over here and we look for the bottom of the band on the antenna tuning, which is 0.60. That's T12. Follow T12 down. That's the far left in the back row. Far left in the back row. Have the tuning tool in. And I get a peek. Wow. Remove the tool. Back the signal generator back a little bit. We don't want to saturate the stage, the detector stage. And now we're going to go for the RF output stage. The RF output stage is the transformer we mentioned. We're going to go to the top of the transformer, and we're going to tune for the output. And it was right on the money. And so now we have a peak. So the bottom two bands now have been tuned as far as the RF output goes. We're going to go up, actually one more band, and keeping in mind that we're going to be doing this so we can tune the bottom slug first in these transformers. The antenna adjustment here, according to the book, is going to start at 4.0, and that'll be the transformer on the second roll. And I should be able to come up here and get a peek. Got a really nice peek there. And then we're going to come back down to the next transformer that starts at 4.0 and tune the bottom of this transformer. Got a nice peak there. And now we've tuned that band. Now we're going to drop back a band and tune the next one. Okay, we're starting at the 2.1 band. We're going to go up to the third transformer and we're going to get a peak. Okay, pull out the tuning tool. Now we're going to go down to the 2.1, which will be the RF adjustment. And 2.1 RF is going to be the top slug in the middle coil. So being careful not to disturb the bottom, we're going to come back up here and get myself a peek. Very careful. There we go. Try that one more time. There we go. All right, so that that band's completed. Okay, as before, we've selected this time again the top band, and then the next one, of course, we'll drop down one. But the top one we've set at 21 megahertz, which is a 15 meter band, and we're going to go ahead and adjust T14. T14 is located right up in the right hand corner, and there's only one adjustment, and we should get one peak. If I can get this thing adjusted in here. Well, almost ended up adjusting the wrong slug here. Not this one, but this one right here. There we go. Easy to do. You might even think a dry marker or something and mark them off as you go. Anyway, we should be able to get a nice peak here. And wow, there we go. Okay, and now we're going to move down and we're going to pick up the bottom slug. The bottom slug here on T21, go all the way down, pick up the bottom slug, and that one's peaked quite nicely. There we go. All right, move up to the last band. Okay, we dropped down a band to 7.85 to 15. And this is the last of the RF adjustments. And we go to the antenna adjustment right here, which is going to be T16. And we're going to peak for a peak. And there's our peak. Well, that one was kind of off. Okay, and then we move back down to the RF output stage, and the RF output stage is going to be the top of the third row right here, and we should go up here for peak, and we got a nice peak there. Okay, so there we go. We've adjusted all of these coils. Each one of these represents a antenna tuning adjustment for each band, and locate the antenna coil adjustment on the chart. And these numbers up here reflect the bottom of the band. So look on the dial of the front of the radio for the appropriate bottom number, and that's the band you're going to be working with. And then same thing up here. Again, start with one up from the bottom. In other words, start with the 1.05 to 2.05 and do that first so that you end up adjusting the bottom slug of the RF output, and then go down a band and adjust the top slug, and then do that each one, bottom, top, bottom, top, and then you should be ready to go. So this is completed now. The RF amplifier stages are all done, and we will do a close-up and personal alignment of the first local oscillator on the next video. Thanks again. This is Pete, K7PP. Appreciate the interest and appreciate your looking. See you on the air.